Hello everyone, welcome to the Deep Web Vault. Today, we're finally continuing exposing the fake Deep Web Season 2 with some counterfeit scams. And oh boy, what a pain in the ass this one was. Thank the FBI for the lack of real visuals and information. Check out our Twitter for more information about that. But anyways, enough whining, let's begin. USJUDZ counterfeit is about as legitimate as it looks. While the website is functional at the least, it looks undeniably sketchy. As for the actual trustworthiness of this site, there is a huge red flag that also comes up later in this video. We've already mentioned this in an episode of Exposing the Fake Deep Web, and it should be used to identify scammers. This being none other than the stupid system of using an email to order. To explain to everyone why this could never work, they'd never be able to differentiate between orders, identify the customers, and thus never be able to deliver their products. Other than this, there would only be one source, which would say that USJUDZ is a scam. That would be a comment on deep.web. The only problem is, the FBI sees the site and now nothing remains of it. Still, based on logic, we can very safely assume that this website is run by scammers. Gutenberg Sprint. You're going to have to put up with the complete lack of related visuals, as the site is offline and our archive on darkwebnews.com has disappeared completely alongside the entirety of the aforementioned site. Regardless, Gutenberg Sprint is a scam with evidence. While we cannot provide any further personal research, somebody on Reddit claims to have done quite a lot of just that, and included this website as one of the many scams they found. The OP of the list was questioned by another fellow Redditor, questioning why they wouldn't include any proof of their research. After an exchange of backs and forths between OP and u/DekuShub, the debate never really had anything come through. But you're smart people, you wouldn't blindly believe a person you don't know. After all, faith is the death of reason, so you deserve info from a more trustworthy source, and in fact, there is. Once we look beneath the surface, we can find onionlist.org, a website you know you can't trust because of their motto, "Scammer crying intensifies." Regardless of the laughably stupid slogan, we might still be able to find some evidence against Gutenberg's, as they claim it's a scam as well. So, where's the evidence? Well, if you're looking for that, you're looking at the wrong place. Having blind faith in one person might be incredibly dumb, but the more the allegations rack up, the more likely it is that the accusers are correct. Gutenberg's print stands at a magnificent 0-2 ratio on the side of those who claim it is a scam, and thus we can believe it to be so. Fake Note Factory. This one was the worst. There is absolutely no documentation of this webpage whatsoever, so we're going to have to purely rely on our ability to find red flags here. Upon scrolling through the entirety of what this website has to offer, we can spot something which we warned you about in the beginning of this video. We told you it would come up again, and here it is. Another order via email scam. Folks, as this one starts popping up more and more on the Onion Wiki, our job is going to get a hell of a lot easier. Other than this, nothing outright screams scammer, and all sources seem to be non-existent, so we're going to rely on logic once again to proclaim Fake Note Factory as a scam. We were also planning on including a fourth and final site known as Black Market Team. Sadly, fate did not let us have the last website, as it is currently down, so we can't check for any red flags there. The other problem is that, because of the generic and overlookable name, specifying what you wanted here was an immensely difficult task, so much so that we couldn't find a single source, be it a journalist website or a person that would even mention the site. For the reasons listed, we are going to have to end the video at only 3 scams. But worry not, next episode will cover escrow scammers, and we have a lot of those, so much so that we might split the video into 2 parts. The Onion Wiki is far more scarce, and it is difficult to find websites in abundance under a single theme, but we will do our best to continue bringing high-quality episodes of the show. Until next week, stay safe, sweet dreams.